The Traveling Salesman Problem is one of the most intensively studied problems in computational mathematics. Given a collection of cities and the cost of travel between each pair of them, cost meaning the amount of miles between them or some other way of measuring, the Traveling Salesman Problem, or TSP for short, is to find the cheapest way of visiting all of the cities and returning to your starting point. In the standard version we study, the travel costs are symmetric in the sense that traveling from city X to city Y costs just as much as traveling from Y to X. The simplicity of the statement of the problem is deceptive. The Traveling Salesman Problem is one of the most intensely studied problems in computational mathematics, and yet no effective solution method is known for the general case. Indeed, the resolution of the Traveling Salesman Problem would settle the P versus NP problem and fetch $1 million prize from the Clay Mathematics Institute. So what we're going to do in this video is solve the Traveling Salesman Problem and collect our bag of money. Joke. Although the complexity of the Traveling Salesman Problem is still unknown, for over 50 years its study has led to the way to improve solution methods in many areas of mathematical optimization. Here's some history behind the Traveling Salesman Problem. As I just stated, the travel costs are symmetric in the sense that traveling from city X to city Y costs just as much as traveling from Y to X. The way of visiting all the cities is simply the order in which the cities are visited. To put it differently, the data consists of integer weights assigned to the edges of a finite complete graph. The objective is to find a Hamiltonian cycle, that is, a cycle passing through all the vertices, or the minimum total weight. The origins of the TSP are obscure. In the 1920s, the mathematician and economist Karl Menger publicized it among his colleagues in Vienna. In the 1930s, the problem reappeared in the mathematical circles of Princeton. In the 1940s, it was studied by statisticians Mihailovich, Chesson, Josh, and Marx in connection with an agricultural application. The mathematician Merrill Flood popularized it among his colleagues at the Rand Corporation. Eventually, the TSP gained notoriety as a prototype of a hard problem in combinatorial optimization. Examining the possible paths one by one is out of the question because of their large number, and no other idea was on the horizon for a long time. By 2004, a research team was working on a TSP with a size of 24,978 cities. So what makes the Traveling Salesman so hard? You may have heard me use this term earlier, but it has a lot to do with the P versus NP problem. So what is the P versus NP problem? It is a question of interest to people working with computers and in mathematics. Basically, it is a question that asks, can every solved problem whose answer can be checked quickly by a computer also be quickly solved by a computer? P and NP are the two types of math problems referred to. P problems are fast for computers to solve, and so are considered easy. The P stands for polynomial time. NP problems are fast and so easy for a computer to check, but are not necessarily easy to solve. The NP refers to non-deterministic time. For instance, if you have a problem and someone says, the answer to your problem is the set of numbers 1 through 5, a computer may be able to quickly figure out if the answer is right or wrong, but it may take a very long time for the computer to actually come up with set 1 through 5 on its own. Anyway, we're a little bit off topic, and the handout in the description of the video will provide more information on this issue. But basically, the P versus NP problem applies to the Traveling Salesman problem in the sense that it is easy to check if you found the cheapest tour, but it isn't easy to actually find the cheapest tour. When developing algorithms for the TSP, researchers look for two factors, efficiency and optimality. Is the algorithm able to find the solution fast, and is it able to find the one correct solution, despite the amount of variables? If one was to create an algorithm that found the optimal tour to any TSP very quickly, it will solve the P versus NP problem and prove that P is equal to NP. Unfortunately, that has not been done. The Traveling Salesman is an NP problem, and so far it has been impossible to find a polynomial algorithm. The algorithms that find the optimal path don't do it very quickly, and the algorithms that operate quickly aren't able to find the optimal path and can only find an approximate of what the actual path would be. We are going to be discussing three types of algorithms for the Traveling Salesman problem: brute force algorithms, heuristic algorithms, and lastly, approximation algorithms. Brute force algorithms, which are guaranteed to find the optimal solution but have no guarantees in terms of running time, and usually taking a reasonably long amount of time depending on how big the problem is. Heuristic algorithms, such as the greedy algorithm, which are guaranteed to run in polynomial time but have no guarantees on the quality of the solution. The greedy algorithm, in particular, isn't very good because it only finds a suboptimal approximate of the best tor and in some cases the worst tor actually. And lastly, approximation algorithms, such as Christofides algorithm, which are guaranteed to run in polynomial time and guaranteed to find high quality solutions, say within 1% of optimal. The main obstacle we face these approximation algorithms is proving a solution's value is close to optimum without even knowing what the optimum value is. So first, let's start with the brute force algorithm. What the brute force algorithm attempts to do is find every single possible solution for a given graph, and then from there on, it's easy to determine whether or not the solution is optimal. This is guaranteed to find the optimal solution, and in theory, this sounds good. But things start to get a little tricky when the number of cities or nodes in the problem are increased. Let's start with 3 nodes. There is 1 possible tor. Easy. With 4 nodes, there are 3 possible tors. Not too bad. Here's where it starts to get crazy. With 5 nodes, there are 12 possible tors. How did we figure this out? As you can see here, we reasoned that a 5th node could be added between each pair of nodes for S of every possible 4th node tor. Here, the actual distances don't matter because we're just trying to count the number of tors. For 6 nodes, we could repeat the process. Add a node to every possible edge of the 12 solutions, 5 node solutions. Since each of the 12 solutions has above 5 edges, it means that we have 12 times 5, which is 60 tors. Notice how fast this grows. Between a graph with 3 nodes and a graph of 6 nodes, our total number of possible tors grew from 1 to 60. This problem grows very quickly. With just 10 nodes, this grows up to 181,440 possible tors. With just 26 nodes, this grows to a 25-digit number that I won't dare try to say. By comparison, so you guys could just vision it, the width of the entire observable universe in miles is roughly a 25-digit number. With 100 nodes, you're up to a roughly 155-digit number. With more nodes, it just becomes insane for a computer to calculate every possible solution. Based on the pattern above, we are able to conclude that with n nodes, there are n-1 factorial divided by 2 possible tors. Meaning, this algorithm runs in exponential time and is unreasonable to use unless the problem is very small. So that leaves us with the choice of using the heuristic and approximate algorithms if we want this to be solved anywhere within our lifetime. One such algorithm is the heuristic algorithm, known as the greedy algorithm. The greedy algorithm earns its name from the way that it operates. It greedily traverses through the edges according to the cheapest nearest node, without any consideration for the most effective path as a whole. It traverses through the graph based on what is locally optimal without consideration for what is globally optimal. Now, although this algorithm runs very quickly in polynomial time, it can sometimes find a close to optimal path. In most cases, the algorithm isn't very useful due to a number of reasons. First, it only works all the time with complete graphs, meaning graphs that are connected everywhere. It may not work for a graph that is not complete. Consider this graph. If we make a complete graph where every node is connected by a weighted edge as follows, then we can perform the greedy algorithm. Here is how the algorithm would work. Starting at H, we'd want to find a tor that hits every vertice but returns to H. We see that the edge from H to D is the cheapest edge, so we take that one first. From D, we see that either T or G is the cheapest edge, so we go to G next since it's alphabetical. From G, we see that G to P is the next cheapest edge, so we go to P next. From P, that leaves the only option of going to C or going to T since all the other nodes have already been visited. We see that C is the cheapest edge from P, so we go to P to C. From C, we go to T, and then back to H to complete the tor. This tor from H to D to G to P to C to T and back to H has a total cost of 274. The optimal solution has a cost of 229. So as you can see, the greedy algorithm yields a mediocre solution. It isn't as far off as some of the other paths, which total in the 200s and low 300s, but then again, it isn't optimal. Now, to return to the fact that the greedy algorithm may not work on a graph that isn't complete, let's look at two different graphs. Both of these graphs are not complete, but what's the difference between them? The difference is the fact that for the graph on the right, the greedy algorithm doesn't work. The greedy algorithm works perfectly fine with the graph on the left, as you can see here. But when we get to the graph on the right, starting at A and finding a tour that loops back to A presents an issue. We would start at A and move to the node connected by 10 next. After that node, we would move to the node connected by 3 and then the node connected by 6, all while picking whichever path is cheapest. And from that node, we will go to the node connected by 9. From this node, we need to get to either of the nodes on top, but since it isn't a complete graph, there is no way of connecting either. Therefore, we run into a dead end and tour is unable to be created from the node where we're at. This is just one of the issues when dealing with the greedy algorithm for the traveling salesman's problem. Another problem with the greedy algorithm is the fact that in the same way it has the potential to find the close to optimum path, it also has the potential to find the close to worst path for graphs with certain structures. Let's revisit our first graph but change it around a little. Let's redistribute some of the weight from the edges so it looks like this. The optimum path from H to C to D to C to G to P and then back to H would still be the same of 229. But if we were to now apply the greedy algorithm, we would first traverse from H to G and then from G to P. From P we would go to D and then from D we would go to T. And from T, we only have the option of going to C and then back to H to create the tour. Do you see what happened here? Although it started out with a low weight which was locally optimum, the weights of the edges quickly increased and there wasn't much the greedy algorithm could do since it already chose that path. Although going from H to G was locally optimum, it wasn't globally optimum. As you can see, the total weight of the tour on this graph is 312, which is terrible compared to the optimum path. It is for these complications that I've just described that the greedy algorithm isn't considered a very effective tool for the traveling salesman's problem, despite the fact that it operates fast. However, there's no need to be a Debbie Downer. There's a better algorithm for solving the TSP than the greedy algorithm, and the brute force algorithm. As I described earlier, the greedy algorithm is a heuristic algorithm, but there is also something called approximation algorithms that not only operate in polynomial time, but return more accurate results. One such algorithm is known as the Christofides algorithm. The only downside to this algorithm is that for it to work, the graph must satisfy the triangle inequality, meaning sum of the two edges must be greater than or equal to the weight of the third edge that is connected by the two. It is proven that the cause of the solution produced by the Christofides algorithm is within 3/2 of the optimum. To prove this, let C be the optimal traveling salesman tool. Removing an edge from C produces a spanning tree, which must have a weight at least that of the minimum spanning tree, implying that the weight of a minimum spanning tree is less than or equal to the weight of the optimal traveling salesman tool. Next, number the vertices, O in cyclic order around C, and partition C into two sets of paths, the ones in which the first path vertex in cyclic order has an odd number, and the ones in which the first path vertex has an even number. Each set of paths corresponds to the perfect matching of O that matches the two endpoints of each path, and the weight of this matching is at most equal to the weight of the paths. Since these two sets of paths partition the edges of C, one of the two sets has at most half of the weight of C, and its corresponding matching has the weight that is also at most half the weight of C. The minimum weight perfect matching can have no larger weight, so the weight of the perfect matching is less than or equal to the weight of the optimum path divided by 2. Adding the weights of minimum spanning tree and the matching gives the weight of the Euler tour at most 3 times the weight of the optimum path divided by 2. Shortcutting does not increase the weight, so the weight of the output is at most 3 times the weight of the optimum path divided by 2. So how does this algorithm work? Here's how it performs. Consider this graph. The first thing that we're going to do is calculate the minimum spanning tree. Next, you calculate the vertices with an odd degree and create a subgraph using only the odd vertices and then construct a minimum weight perfect matching for the subgraph. A perfect matching is where every vertex is connected by one edge. After that, you combine the perfect matching with the minimum spanning tree and now you have a graph where every vertex has an even degree. You can now calculate Euler tour since every vertex has an even degree. A Euler tour is a cycle that visits every edge in the graph. When you create the eulatory, take shortcuts so that you don't visit the same vertices twice. Thus, you end up with a solution that visits every vertex in a cost-effective manner. It's easy to tell that the optimal solution for this very simple graph is 5. Using Christofides' method, we get a solution of 6, which is as close to optimal for this particular graph, and for graphs on a much larger scale, the solution remains just as close. To review, the traveling salesman is a very hard problem that might be impossible to solve in an efficient and correct manner, but people are still trying anyway. We've discussed 3 types of algorithms for solving it. The brute force algorithm, which returns the optimal solution, but only after a very long time. The greedy algorithm, which is fast but doesn't work for most problems, and Christofides' algorithm, which is pretty fast and returns a solution within 3 halves of the optimal. Obviously, there are hundreds of other algorithms that people have devised over the years for solving the traveling salesman's problem. None of them work though. There are several cool applications of the TSP, which you can find in the handout in the description. I hope you've enjoyed this video and learned something new about the traveling salesman's problem.